This conference will now be recorded.
So we have here this one. So welcome everyone for the Shiva Maharatri Puja and Mantra actually. And I wanted to do this for a very long time so that people can know what how to do the Shiva Puja and everything. Okay. So this is the first webinar that we are going to do over here, and this is just a general introduction. I wanted to share a few prayers with you so that you can start learning it before the Shivratri, and these are very nice prayers. Sonal Didi will of course do the Shanti mantras. She has added they are very good Shanti mantras, and it is very beneficial for everybody to do this because everybody's life is full of chaos and full of problems, and these mantras actually really help a lot. Shall we start, Didi?
Yes.
Yes, this is
Welcome,
I've just added this Ganesh mantra actually, because anything, any auspicious beginning that we do actually, so we have to worship Ganesh. Before, without worshiping Ganesh, there's nothing we can achieve. Most of us have our own Ganesh mantra we can do with that actually. But those who don't have a Ganesh mantra, this is a very good 16-letter mantra that actually removes all the obstacles from one's life. And this mantra has to be done before starting the puja. Anybody can do this mantra. It has no obligations, no problems. It's a very prasiddha mantra. It was given by Radhika to Lord Krishna. And this mantra is Om Gam Glom Ganpate Vigna Vinashane Swaha. I'll repeat this mantra. Om Gam Glom Ganpate Vigna Vinashane Swaha. As you can see, yeah,
Akshat
hello.
ji, hello, it's Sophia, if you remember me, Israel.
Yeah.
So, would we get like the mantras in a document?
Translate the mantras actually offer, and let's just get with because the session has been recorded actually for those who were not able to join. So we can continue with the questions after the session actually. This is the first session actually. This is just introductory. Okay.
All I'm asking is the documentation of like a
I'll
PDF.
send it. Well, yeah, you'll get the documentation afterwards actually.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah. So this mantra can be done anybody who is facing a lot of obstacles in life, who's having a court case or some problems at home. This is a very good mantra actually. It is a 16th level and it actually maps to your fourth house. So any problem within the heart, this mantra has the power to dissolve. Whenever you're starting a puja, whenever you're doing anything new, if you do this mantra, this is a very good mantra. Om Gam Glom Ganpate Vigna Vinashane Swaha. I'll be sending this the PDF as you first said actually, and you'll get this mantra. Now this is a very good prayer actually. Those most of us don't know about this prayer. This prayer was taught to me in Shiv Mahapuran actually, and this is a prayer when we worship Shambhu actually. Shiv has a lot of different names, and the power of the name Shambhu is that he actually forgives all her mistakes or her sins. So when we if we have done something, if you have want to ask forgiveness to the Lord, this is the name we have to refer to him as Shambhu actually. This was the prayer that has been done by Lord Vishnu when he asking for Diksha from Lord Shiva and asking for his knowledge actually. Every day in once in the morning, if you do this prayer, you will ask for forgiveness for your sins. You will also ask for knowledge and a peaceful life. This is a big prayer actually, but I hope everybody can learn it. It's not a very tough one, it's very easy actually. And it's read as Namo Nishkal Rupaye Namo Nishkal Tejase Namah Sakalatmaye Namaste Sakalatmane Namah Pranavavachaye Namah Pranavalingine Namah Srishti Adi Karte Cha Namah Panchamukhayate पंच ब्रह्मा स्वरूपाय पंच कृताय ते नमः आत्मने ब्रह्मणे तुभ्यं अनंत गुण शक्ते सकला काल रूपाय शंभवे गुरवे नमः। सो लॉर्ड विष्णु इज एड्रेसिंग शिवा लॉर्ड शिवा विद अ लॉट ऑफ डिफरेंट नेम्स एंड वन ऑफ द मेन थिंग्स दैट वी हैव टू रिमेंबर दैट ही इज एड्रेसिंग लॉर्ड शिवा एज पंच मुखायते। पंच मुखायते मीन्स वन हु हैज फाइव हेड्स एक्चुअली। ओके एंड ही इज ऑल्सो एड्रेसिंग हिम एज शंभवे गुरवे नमः। He's also addressing Lord Shiva as a guru or a Shambhu. He's asking for forgiveness. He's asking for knowledge. He is praising him that he is the source and everything, and he has the omnipotent and he's omnipowerful actually. This is a prayer that everyone should do in the beginning of the day, so that they ask for forgiveness of the sins and their karma dissolved and their life is peaceful and they may grant knowledge of salvation. Anybody has any doubts can speak with this prayer. I will be sending a audio note also so that you can study this prayer actually.
What is Nishkal Rupai means?
Pardon? Nishkal Rupai. Nishkal Rupai means that one who does not have a rope actually. Because when you go into the philosophy of Lord Shiva, Shiva is all jnana and the body embodiment of knowledge does not have a physical form. That is why we worship Shiva in a Shiva Linga actually. The moment Shiva takes a form, he takes a form in the form of a Rudra actually. Pure Shiva is Omkara. He does not have any form. He does not have an end or he does not have a beginning actually. Can you understand now?
Yeah.
Hello?
Thank you.
Okay, so yes. That is why, because the real form of Sadashiva is in the form of Adi Guru. He is pure knowledge. He does not have an embodiment actually. He is there. That is why we worship Shiva in a Shiva Linga actually. The moment you start making statues of Shiva of blue color, of black color, of any color actually, that is the form of Rudra. Shiva is white in color and he has to be worshipped in a Shiva Linga. Now, this is a very basic puja that I want to tell you, and everybody can do it. It's called Panch Upchar Puja, actually. Now, we have heard that the Shiva having five heads, and these five heads actually tell he creates the five tattvas that maintain life, sustain life, and create life, actually. So, when we do the Panch Upchar Puja, what we are doing, Panch means five, and Upchar means that we are treating the five elements that are within us and surround us so that we can pacify these elements and we can make our life peaceful, easygoing, and good, actually. So, this is a very, very peculiar puja, and it has the power to pacify all the planets, all the rashis in your horoscope, and all the bad things. And it's a puja that can be done every day. And it is one of the most simple pujas, actually. All we need to do is to offer the five elements to the Shiva Linga. Whenever we offer something to Shiva Linga, remember that whatever you will offer, you'll get it back. So whenever you're going to offer something good, you're going to get back good. So we start with burning an incense stick. When we burn incense stick, hello? So when we burn an incense stick, actually, so what we are doing, we are activating the Vayu Tattva. So the first step is to offer an incense stick to a Shiva Linga. We just burn a Shiva incense stick and we just offer it to the Shiva Linga by saying, Om Namah Shivaya Dhupam Agrayami. Okay. Now, once we have done the offer the incense stick, then we are pacifying the Vayu Tattva. The next is to pacify the Agni Tattva. Then we have to light a lamp. And when we light a lamp, we offer it to Lord Shiva Linga and we say, Om Namah Shivaya Deepam Darshayami. Fire has to see. Agni has the power to see. Agni has the power to learn. So we say, Darshayami means that you, okay, please see this lamp. And with the light of this lamp, my whole life will be full of light and joy and knowledge. The second thing is that we offer sandalwood paste, that is Prithvi Tattva. We offer. What we do, we take a sandalwood stick, we rub it, and we make a paste, and we offer it on Shiva Linga with the third and the fourth finger. We do not use the index finger to touch the Shiva Linga. Okay. When we offer Prithvi Tattva, it pacifies the Prithvi Tattva. Prithvi Tattva denotes our physical form, denotes our material wealth. So when we start offering the Prithvi Tattva, our physical form, if we're having some problems in physical, suppose someone having a former problem with arthritis, the body is getting deformed, or someone's having a financial problem, when we offer start offering Prithvi Tattva, sandalwood paste, slowly, slowly, those problems will start going to dissolve, actually. Now, the fourth part is that we have to offer Naivedyam. Naivedyam is something that you're going to eat. It is also called prasadam. But before it is offered, it's called Naivedyam. You can offer anything that you like. You can offer sweets. You can offer jaggery. You can offer anything that you want to eat. And you can offer to Lord Shiva Linga so that he may accept that offer. Now, Naivedyam is coming from Jala Tattva. Jala Tattva has to do with our food, with our relationships, with our emotions. When we start offering Naivedyam, or we can offer Naivedyam and something to drink like water or a milk. So what happens when you offer that? All our relationship problems or our emotional issues are taken care of. And we also start having, receiving good food actually. And the last and the most important is flowers. When we offer flowers to a Shiva Linga, so it activates the Akash Tattva. Akash Tattva is one of the most important tattvas, because without it, nothing is going to be at its place. Akash Tattva is the gravitational force that puts together all the tattva to get its place. Akash Tattva is the power of attraction. It is the power of love when it is positive. It is the power of hate when it is negative. So we should always be offering flowers to a Shiva Linga so that our Akash Tattva is cleansed and maintained. How can we? So what will happen? All the love, affection, and the good things in a life are maintained. Anybody who is having problems with emotional problems or problems with something like mental disease or like depression, they should always offer flowers to Shiva Linga so that their mental calmness and mental integrity is maintained, because Akash Tattva directly influence on the mind actually. Does anybody have the problem to do that? Any questions?
So could you please repeat kindly the mantras for each of the tattvas?
See, yeah, the first tattva is for the Vayu tattva is Dhupa. Dhupa, we say in English, we call it incensing. Om Namah Shivaya Dhupam Agrayami. Okay, now when you light
Dhupam Agrayami.
Agrayami, yeah. It is, has to do with the smell actually, okay?
Okay, sir.
Then we are offering the lamp. Then we have to say Om Namah Shivaya Deepam Darshayami, because you are seeing the lamp. You are not accepting. Nobody likes to put a burning stick on you. You actually see it, right?
Darshayami.
Darshayami. Yeah, Darshan. Darshan means to see.
Okay, sir.
Okay.
Akshay ji, will you be sharing this presentation or recording later after this, so that we will not be,
because I'll be sending you this PDF actually, okay? So that you can learn with this actually, okay? Before the Shivratri Puja, I'll send it actually, okay?
Okay, sir.
Okay. Now with the sandalwood paste, with Naivedya and flowers, you offer it. So Om Namah Shivaya Gandharva Sarpayami, you are giving away. With the same with the Jala Tattva, Om Namah Shivaya Naivedyam Sarpayami and Om Namah Shivaya Pushpam Sarpayami. You are actually submitting to the Lord. If anyone who does this puja every day over a period of 1 year, they will say that their life has become very calm. Most of their problems have dissolved actually. It is a very good puja that you can do every morning. Once you wake up, you take a bath and you start doing the Panch Upchar puja. So every day you are pacifying all the five tattvas, and your life is, the quality of the life is maintained. Okay. Any questions more?
What if my attraction into a different aspect of divinity, not Shiva? What should I do?
If you have a different attraction to a different deity, actually.
Yes. This will upgrade the quality of my life, but I'm practicing devotion to a different aspect of the Supreme.
See, this aspect of the prayer is that, see, what is, why we are worshipping Lord Shiva with all the five elements actually? Because when you, Shiva is the only one who creates all the five elements actually, okay? He is in the form of Panch Brahma Shiva actually. So he's creating the five elements. So when he's creating the five elements, we all have some affliction to every element actually. And the element which is afflicted the most will be the cause of our death. So what we are doing, that when we offering this, we are remedying the afflicted elements in our body actually, okay? So once we start afflicting, so that the problem, the elements that are afflicted in our body, in our chart, they start to get remedied actually, so that they will not create problems. There are other upchar pujas also for other deities also, and there are different procedures actually. Okay. Ophir, can you send me your question in the group actually?
I will.
Okay, sure.
I will.
So can we do this in Sandhya Vela as well? That is in the evening as well?
You can do it in the morning or in the evening. Remember that after sunset, you are not going to do Abhishek of Lord Shiva. Okay, because sun is represented by Shiva, and the when the sun is set, you cannot do Abhishek. Except the night of a Shivaratri. Otherwise, you when the sun is set, you cannot do the Abhishek. Abhishek means that you are bathing the Shivalinga with water, actually. You cannot do that. But you can do the Panch Upchar Puja anytime. The best time is to do it in the morning with the sunrise and at the sunset, at the Sunday. Okay? Any more questions? People who does not have a Shivalinga at home, they can go to the nearby temple if they are available. And if anybody does not have a temple nearby and they do not have a Shivalinga at home, what they can just imagine, they can imagine that they have a white Shivalinga in front of them and they are offering them in the mind. That is called Manas Panch Upchar Puja. Because Shiva will also take something that you offer by mind. He is everywhere. Shall we proceed?
Now, this Akshati, is a very one question.
Yeah.
Can we also do this for Ganesh Bhagwan, Panchotpar, and use the same thing? The mantras will be different.
The mantras will change, the vidhi will change, but all the devtas will have their Upchar Puja actually. Okay. But the best Panchopchar Puja is done for Shivalinga. Okay. Because when you study the parts of the Shivalinga, I will hoping to teach you in the next part, there are different parts of the Shivalinga. Ganesh is always at the bottom of the Shivalinga.
Okay.
Okay. At the bottom of the Shiva. Ganesh is always, so once you, if you're doing Panch Upchar on the Shivalinga, actually you are doing Upachar of Devi, of Mahadev, of Ganesh, Vishnu and Rudra. All these devtas are covered in the Shivalinga actually. That is why in Vedic text, Shivalinga is one of the most sacred objects. Okay. And this is the Shiv Panchakshi Sotra. This is a very beautiful Sotra actually. Okay. Those who cannot do puja, those who cannot do things, I would like that they start singing this Sotra actually. It's a very beautiful Sotra and it is made of the mantra Namah Shivaya. That is the Mool Mantra of Lord Shiva. Om Namah Shivaya is the Sadakshi Mantra, is the six letter mantra. And Namah Shivaya is the Panchakshi Mantra. In this, the Om is Sukshma, that you do not speak it. So Namah Shivaya is five letters. Actually, this is what happens. It is clearing all the five tattvas and dissolving their imbalances actually. Okay. And this is a very beautiful Sotra. This is a very beautiful Sotra, which can be done by everybody. So near a Shivalinga, it can be done. If you don't have a Shivalinga near, then you can recite it or you can sing it at your own time so that all the five tattvas, all the affliction to all the five tattvas are dissolving. And this is a Sotra that is loved by Lord Shiva very much. I think most of you have heard this Sotra in India. Does anybody do this Sotra?
Yes.
Okay. So it's a very beautiful sutra. The sutra says Nagendra Haraya Trilochanaya Bhasmangaraya Maheshwaraya Nityaya Shuddhyaya Digambaraya Tasmaya Nakaraya Namah Shivaya. So the first tattva that we are killing is the Na. Okay. We again Mandakini Salil Chandana Charchitaya Nandishwara Pramatnath Maheshwaraya Mandare Pushpe, Bahu Pushpe Supujitai, Tasmai Makarai, Namah Shivaya. Shivaya Gauri, Vadanab Jevande, Suryai, Daksha Dhavare Nashakai, Sri Neel Kantai, Vrishdhojai, Tasmai Shikarai, Namah Shivaya. Vasishta Kumbhote Bhave Gautamariai, Munindra Devar Chit Shekharai, Chandrarka Vaishwa Nar Lochanai, Tasmai Vakarai, Namah Shivaya. यज्ञ स्वरूपाय जटाधराय पिनाक हस्ताय देवाय दिगंबराय तस्मय यकाराय नमः शिवाय पंचाक्षी मिद्यम पुण्यम या पटेशी सन्निधौ शिव लोक माप्नोति शिवेना सह मोदते. सो यू कैन सी दैट ईच एंड एवरी श्लोका इज स्टार्टिंग विद द लेटर वन ऑफ द लेटर्स ऑफ नमः शिवाय. सो एनीबॉडी हु डज ओम नमः शिवाय और नमः शिवाय at least one mala 108 times or four malas and does this sotra. So what will happen? The energy of the Shiva, the knowledge of the Shiva with the Panchupchar, they are starting to create something very positive and they are starting to dissolve the tattva afflictions in their life. Anybody who does this sotra is saying, who will actually get moksha, will go to Shiva Loka and Shivena, all the Shiva Gana will always actually help him. This is one of the best sotras. Anybody who has any type of problem with tattva doshas, any type of doshas which are relating to any of the tattvas, they can do this and they can gain benefit. Actually, it has to be done every day, because with the Shiva thing, we have to remember that when you start worshipping Shiva, it has to be done every day so that the energy is maintained. Just singing this sotra near a Shiva Linga can pacify all the afflictions for during the day. Hello?
Any sir, question? Hello?
Yeah, yeah. Ask, please.
So I have a doubt. This Shiva Panchakshari Stotram, which you taught, it is to be read once in morning, once in evening, or 108
times? Once. After, if you are doing the Shiva, if you are doing the Panchakshari Mantra, that is Namah Shivaya, okay? In which, when you start doing the Panchakshari Mantra, Namah Shivaya, in which you inhale Om and speak Namah Shivaya, and after if you do this Sotra, it's actually very good, actually. What is happening, actually, when you see, if you see your horoscope, everybody will have a lot of doshas, and all these planets are actually nothing but showing the doshas of the tattva, because each and every planet is governing a certain tattva. Okay, and when we go into the deep cause of the problem, some people say that, oh, they have done so many pujas, domains in there, and they have so many remedies of these plants, but the problem is persisting, not going. Then we show that the problem is very deep level, deep rooted, and it is at the level of the tattva. Then we have to go to the tattva, because these are the tattvas that creating all the plants, and they have created everything. These are the root cause that have created us. And if we pacify them, then the problem is cleared from the root, actually. Okay.
Actually, I wrote my question.
Let me see, actually. Okay, yeah, you wrote it in the this chat. Actually, I wanted you in the WhatsApp group so that everybody can see. Okay. Okay, I love Shivaji, but I don't talk to Krishna.
And they teach that Kli Krishna Govinda Gopijan Ravaya Swa is sufficient against all ill effects. So, where do you stand?
What do you think? So there are different schools of thought, actually. Okay. Of it. Hello?
Yes.
Okay, there are different schools of thought. And this is the dispute that you're talking about, the Shaivite and the Vishnoite is going for centuries, actually. People say that Vishnu is the best. Some people say that Shiva is the best. Don't go into these thoughts, actually. Okay. You need purity and you need strength. Vishnu is absolute purity and Shiva is absolute strength. And this strength is coming from the knowledge, actually. Those, so don't indulge, okay, you have to worship Krishna or you have to worship Shiva. You can worship both. There is no dispute in that. Okay.
Can I answer that question? And I think it would be good if Akshat can proceed. But let me just quickly answer that, because I encountered that question even for the other Jyotish class. Essentially, as per what our Jyotish Guru Pandit Sanjay Rath has always maintained, is that Shiva is always in deep meditation on Vishnu, and Vishnu yes. is always looking for Shiva always. So it is not that it's one or the other. There is no division between them, you know. So you, that's a very fundamental thing that you have to understand. And whether you're a Shaivite or any Shaiva parampara you follow or Vaishnav parampara, it is irrelevant, because the fact of the matter is that Shiva is always in deep meditation for a Vishnu, which is Ram, right? So that's yes. That's all I wanted to add. And I think we should have the questions in the chat in yes. That will be, because we want to proceed with the
Thank you.
In the WhatsApp group. So because this is a thing that a lot of people say, there's no distinction, actually. What you can see that all the Jyotirlingas in India have been established by Vishnu. Vishnu is always worshipping Shiva, and Shiva is always worshipping Vishnu, because you cannot have one without the other. You need purity to gain strength, and you need strength for maintaining the purity. Shiva is sitting in the 1 and 7 axis of your horoscope, and Vishnu is sitting in the 4 and 10 axis of your horoscope. You need both the 4 kendras to maintain your life. So if you're saying that, no, you have to have worship of Krishna only, or you have to worship of Shiva only, that is actually totally wrong. You need everything. You need to worship Devi, you need to worship Vishnu, you need to worship Shiva, and you need to worship Ganesha. All these devtas are very important because these are the prime devtas that are controlling life. That is why we have to see that Om Namah Shivaya has, Namah Shivaya has 5 variables. A, U, Ma, Na, De, Bindu also have 5 variables. So we need this because the mythology, and we have to say that Shiva as the form of Sadashiva is from which animated everything. So he is not distinguished. He can take the form of Vishnu. Vishnu can be Shiva. It's a very, very intermingling concept actually. Do not confuse with that, because what will people say? There is nothing, those, nobody is going to win. Worship what you like to worship, but you cannot say, oh, this is better, that is better. That distinction cannot be made actually. Am I clear?
Yes, thank you.
Sonalila, I think you are going to do the Shanti partner mantras and introduce them to what is the meaning of the Shanti mantras.
Okay, this is from the Ishavasya Upanishad, and even I think Taittiriya or one other Upanishad also carries this mantra, the Apyayantu mantra. Now, the whole ethos of Shanti mantra.
The webcam is closed actually, I think. People like to see you. A lot of people doesn't know.
Oh, okay. Sorry. Okay. Is that okay?
Yeah.
Okay. So the whole ethos of the Shanti mantra is peace for everyone, you know, and that doesn't mean like running away from conflict, but ultimately the peace is what you are all and we are all seeking, peace on earth. And unless the mind is peaceful, we cannot proceed even for mantra practice or any kind of puja. We have to begin with a Shanti mantra in my view, and we have to end with a Shanti mantra. And this particular mantra is fantastic because there are many other ones which we will come to, but in my view, this one from the Upanishad is one of the most beautiful because it talks about one's own the 5 senses and how do you manage it and let Brahma look after it and let Brahma not be, you know, be within me always and not leave me in any way, nor do I want to leave Brahma. So in a way, this is sort of very fundamentally appealing to all the senses and let my senses always work perfect harmony. I think we cannot ever underestimate the power of the Shanti mantra because it is for everyone. And most importantly, it is for us. And I don't think that it won't be effective because it's like just for myself. And what can, I don't have a voice. I'm just like one mantra. How can it, you'll be surprised if, the power of this particular mantra as well. Anyway, so if you guys want to unmute yourself, feel free because I can wait because it has to be said in a certain way with proper stops. So feel free to unmute. Is that okay? Everyone?
Okay.
Okay? Okay. So, Om Apyayantu. Hello. You
yes,
can
yes,
feel
please.
Free to repeat. Yeah, you can unmute yourselves, all of you, if you want. Akshat?
Yes, yes, yes. I think everybody can unmute themselves. Nobody's unmuting, actually.
Okay, fine. Okay.
You just recorded because they'll get recording, actually, no matter
okay,
what.
Okay, fine. Om Apyayantu Mamangani Vak Pranak Chakshu Shot यत्र मथो बलमिंद्रियाणि च सर्वाणि सर्वं ब्रह्मोपनिषदं माहं ब्रह्म निराकुर्याम मामा ब्रह्म निराकरोत् अनिराकरणम् अस्त्वनिराकरणम् मे अस्तु तदात्मनि निरतेय उपनिषत्सु धर्मास्ते मयि सन्तु ते मयि सन्तु ॐ शांति शांति शांति। Okay.
Beautiful mantra, actually. I just love it.
Yeah, this is
also very well, actually.
Thank you.
Your moon is much better than mine, actually.
I've been trying to practice, but it's really good. But the beauty about this mantra is that you can say this at the beginning of your, because typically people have this impression that Shanti mantras have to be said at the end of it. I like this mantra because this can be said right at the beginning of any puja and then at the end as well.
See, that is the reason, actually, that is the better way to do it, because until unless before you have to do the Shanti mantra. That is why I told you that you should do the Shanti mantra, because when you're going for a Vedic puja and you are actually summoning the deity, and the deity is going to sit in your hip chakra. So you need your heart to be peaceful, actually. Okay. So if you do the Shanti mantra so that you can peacefully do the puja, you need to do the Ganesh mantra so that there are no obstacles during the puja. These mantras are very important, actually, because until you cannot recall, you cannot call a deity and say that, oh, and you have, and you're thinking about some aggression or some problem is still going inside your heart, and your whole consciousness over there focusing on that problem, so that a lot of rajas or tamas is created inside the heart. So it is better to do a Shanti mantra than to Ganesh mantra and to do a Guru mantra. That is why I added the prayer and the Ganesh mantra that I had not added, because people need to follow proper procedure. They need to find that the heart is very composed and calm, then take the name of Ganesh, then take the name of Guru and start doing the Vedic puja. And at the end also they need to do the Shanti mantra so that if they have done anything wrong or mistake, or there have been some anger inside their heart during the puja, that is specified. Because the Devta is only going to reflect what is inside your heart.
Yeah.
It was a very beautiful mantra. Can we go on to, you can, shall we, should I go on to the next mantra? Let's see this. This is a,
everybody knows this. I think we can all unmute
ourselves. I wanted it to record, actually, because I'm hoping that if anybody doesn't know the Shiv Panchakshari Sotra, since you're singing it very well, I want you to record, teach them the Shiv Panchakshari Sotra also, because you know that my Mars is in the seventh house, in the aspect in the second. I do mantras with a lot of Agni, but you have a lot of sweetness in the voice.
I don't think so.
That is the thing, no, actually. You say that Mars in the seventh house, you just like a politician giving speech. It's not very good for singing.
I am not very, this is not a mantra. This is a very popular mantra, but Shanti mantra, but I don't, it's very common, but it's very beautiful too. You know, Hom Sarva Bhavantu Sukhinah Sarva Santu Niramayah Sarva Bhadrani Pashyantu Ma Kashchid Dukha Bhavan Bhag Bhavet. Now Like I said, this is kind of quite short, and it's not a mantra that I'm very, very super familiar with because I don't recite this. There is the other one, Home Sad, you know, the Asutoma Sadgamaya.
Yeah.
I like this one a lot, and then the Purnamada one as well. So within what I would encourage everyone is to basically find their favorite Shanti mantra, because it's something quite personal and you have to love singing it, you know, otherwise it's kind of pointless if you're just doing it like an exercise, you know. Anyway, so this is the third one. Om Asatoma Sadgamaya Tamaso ma jyotirgamaya mrityorma amritam gamaya om shanti shanti shanti. So yeah, I like this one a lot too.
Actually, I'm a bit lazy one, so I do the simple om prabhu shanti shanti shanti.
Simple. Ah, okay.
Yeah, because you know that with all the mantras and all the things actually, so I just say that Om Krishna Shanti or Prabhu, but this is actually very beautiful mantras actually. Okay.
Yeah.
Everybody can unmute themselves. They want to talk, they can, you can talk freely and ask questions, because there are a lot of stuff actually that we have talked through actually. Okay. And the most important thing that we need to focus, that people need to learn the Ganesha mantra and they need to do this prayer actually. This is a very beautiful prayer, because if you start doing it, especially for ones who are studying or what have some kind of problem, it's a very good prayer to initiate into Shiva Puja actually.
Yeah.
Okay. And it's a very beautiful, and this is also a very good
Hello, Akshat.
Audio seems to have gone, Akshat.
Yeah, it's fine. I can hear you, Shyamla ji.
Hello?
Yeah, now we can hear you, Akshat.
It's back now. Yeah, okay. Hello, Akshat?
Again, Akshat's voice is gone.
I know. Akshat?
His camera and voice are, most probably his internet connectivity must have gone off.
Yeah. So, Shyamla ji, talking about Shanti Mantra, what is your favorite one?
Om Purnamada Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudaschate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate Om Shanti Shanti, Shanti.
Can you share this mantra in the group actually?
Pardon me?
Can you share this mantra in the group?
I'll send it to you.
Beautiful, Shyamla ji. That's absolutely beautiful. It's one of my favorites too.
Yes. This was the one which Guruji had given us earlier.
Yes. That this is also an Upanishadic mantra, you know. It's actually from the Vedanta, one of the Vedantas. It's beautiful.
Yeah.
Yes. I think that anybody has any questions actually, because we are going to meet on Tuesday in the night, around same time actually. And I'm going to teach you the Pancha Brahma Shiva mantras actually. Okay. And we'll go on to all these details actually, which mantra in which pair of the Shivratri you have to do, what are the things and everything. So if you have any questions, you can ask right now actually, so that we can have a good session. Anybody, you can unmute yourselves and can ask.
Can I please ask you two questions?
Yeah, sure.
Sir, first question which I was asking is that you told that if I am singing the Shiva Tandava Stotra in front of a Sthita Linga on a regular basis. So what is a Sthita Linga?
No. You have to sing the Shiva Tandava Stotra when you establish the Shiva Linga on the Sri Pitha actually.
Oh, okay. Okay. What is a Sri Pitha, sir?
Sri Pitha is that you have to get a Sri Yantra made actually according to your chart. We have to see which Atmakarak you are, then the metal we have to choose. Then we have to do your Nakshatra Puja on that, your Jan Nakshatra Puja on the Sri Yantra. Then we have to establish the Sri Yantra in a Puja altar. Then after that, we have to place the Shiva Linga. Okay, so this is a very elaborate process actually. You need to start doing it, then you have to do continuously worship the Shiva Linga at your home. Then we have, that is how you do it actually. So Shiva pujas are very, very elaborate. So we try to keep it simple so that everybody can do it.
Okay. And sir, another small doubt. So personally, you know, apart from normal Shiva mantras, I also do Lord Shiva's Somnath mantra on a regular basis. So see, on the Shivaratri,
you can do any mantra that you like.
Okay, sir.
Means we are allowed. Teach the Sonal Didi is going to teach the Jyotirlinga mantras. Actually, she has been willing to teach because I have requested her to teach everybody all the Jyotirlinga mantras, actually, all the 12 Jyotirlinga mantras of Lord Shiva, and she is willing to teach. Are you going to teach, Sonal Didi?
Yeah, yeah. Hello? I'm happy to.
I think we have to prepare it. We have to fastly prepare the slides actually for, because it's on Tuesday only, actually. Okay.
Yeah.
You can do any Shiva mantra that you like, actually. Okay. That is, no, they are plethora of Shiva mantras, actually. If I started teaching all the Shiva mantras, it will be, I think, this webinar will start going on for 2 to 3 days, actually. There are so many Shiva mantras, actually.
I know. There are thousands. Many.
Yeah. Guruji taught us about 45 days in Shiva Mahapurana, actually, all the mantras and all. It took 45 days, and that was only the first two samhitas, not the whole 8 samhitas.
Okay, thank you, sir.
Okay, so if you see, you ask a question about how to get longevity and sustenance, actually. See, longevity and sustenance, both are coming from Shiva, actually. Shiva, without Shiva, you cannot have any wealth. Please be sure, actually. Lakshmi is only sitting where there is Shiva. Lakshmi is the sister of Shiva, it is believed. And no matter what you do, if you do not have the blessings of Shiva, you will not have any wealth. Astrologically, when you see the chart, sun, that the Pratyadi Devta of sun is Shiva, and sun is the one who gives all the wealth. So if you do not have the blessings of the sun or the Shiva, you will not have any resources, actually, no matter what a person does. If you take it from the studies of, you can see from Ramayana, Raman was a demon, but he used to only worship Shiva. He had all the wealth he could have, and he wrote the Shiva Tandav Sutra.
Okay, thank you, sir.
Okay, any more questions? I don't think that anybody is going to have any questions, actually. Okay. And
I do, but he told me to. He told me to write my questions later.
Yeah. So, you have a very complex question, actually, Ophir, actually. It is not because there is no right or wrong answer, actually. Because you are talking about conflicting of thoughts. There are two ideologies of Vishnu's and the Shiva's, actually. And everybody is giving their own opinion. Because we do not go into that dispute, actually. Who is superior, Shiva or Vishnu? We worship them both. Are you getting my point?
I know. I'm familiar with this, with these concepts, and yes, functionally, to us in our daily householder normal life, to improve our situation, normally the Shivaite mantras are more potent. This is an experience.
See, all the mantras will work.
Who is superior?
No, it's not there. Vishnu mantra will also work. Shiva mantra is also work. We have to see that which path you're going to follow. Okay.
I'll discuss this with you later.
Yeah, which path you're going to follow, actually. Okay. And which path you have to follow. So people, you don't have to just confuse yourself. Oh, this is the better part or this is the better. They are both there. Both the paths lead to the same way. The ending is the one with the moksha. You only want to get moksha when you're going to dissolve all your karma. And all the karma once dissolved actually is going what to that? It's going to the sukshma pansakshi, that is a, uma, nad and bindu. It will go away when you read about the higher philosophies actually.
Yes, I did.
Okay.
As much as I could.
Yes, yes. Okay. So this is how you're going to. So I want everybody to learn this prayer actually. I'll send a voice text for everybody so that they can learn it properly and they can sing it every day in the morning, especially on the night of Shivaratri actually. It is a very good to worship Shivaratri. It is very good to do the puja, because once you do the puja of the four, this Tattva pujas of all the five heads of Shiva on the Shivaratri, so you are covered for whole year actually, till the next Shivaratri actually. Okay. And the things that people who are India can do it in a temple, or do you have a Shivalinga, you can get it done in your Shivalinga at your home. There are very few things that you're required to have for the puja. You need to have an incense stick, you need to have a lamp, okay, you need to have some sweets, you need to have some flowers and some sandalwood paste actually. That is the whole thing, that is the minimum five things that you need, and you are done with the Shiva puja. You don't need to go to find something really elaborate or do something much more expensive. It's a very simple and it can be done by everybody. Okay, those who don't have a Shiva Linga cannot go to a Shiva temple. Just sit down in the night during the Shivaratri and I'll teach you at during what time, what mantras have to be done, how they have to be done, and just chant that mantras actually. Nothing else has to be done. Okay, because when we come that, we will see that the five heads of Shiva are creating all the five elements, and they are Sadyojata, Vamdev, Aghorata, Kursh and Ishana. Okay, and these teach them what are the bijas, what are their main mantras that can be done by everybody during the night. Those who cannot do anything, I'll prescribe them just chant Om Namah Shivaya. That is one of the best mantras to remove all your problems, because that mantra is coming to your sixth house. All your shadripus, all your enmity, all your bad habits in life will go, all your diseases will go away with that. So we are going to meet on Tuesday at the same time. I think we are done.
Amen.
For this. Yes. I think we should call it over there, Didi.
Okay. Yeah. Shyamla ji, what do you, can I ask you some questions? What do you do typically on Mahashivratri? I know two Shivratris ago we were all together in Bhimtal, you know.
There are different ways people do it here, depending upon their convenience and other things. So the first is you do the normal pujas in the morning, you start and we have a fast. Now the whole day people don't eat anything. They only may be eating, some of them eat sweet potato. That is one of the traditional things which they eat on Shivaratri. Other than that, they don't eat anything else. And the whole day, there many people are there without even drinking water and they keep a fast. And then every prahara, they do pujas and abhishek.
Yes. This is the thing that we are going to teach, but every prayer, but we are going to do that every prayer in the night.
Yeah, but here they normally follow it right from the morning till the next day.
Yes.
Because so when we got our Diksha for the Shiva thing, when we were in Bhimtal 2 years ago, if you recall, we did not eat anything since early morning.
The fasting
towards the day. But we did break our fast, I think, in the afternoon, I think.
The reason was you took the prasad in the temple. Once the prasad is taken, that means your fast is broken.
Yeah, absolutely.
Even in Satyanarayan Puja, there are people who do it in the morning sometimes. And if they have taken the prasad immediately after the puja, that means their fast is broken.
See, that is a lot of people actually. See, what is the thing is that once you start the Shivaratri Vrata, it will start with the Chaturdashi actually. Okay. In the morning, and we start doing abhishek. The first abhishek, that is the foremost abhishek, is when done at the sunset, when the first prayer of the night is started, because it is called Shivaratri. It has to be worshipped in the night, the first prayer. Okay, then the puja will be continued for every pair of the, there were four pairs till night, and during the sunrise in the morning actually, okay, when the sun is rising, then we actually end up the puja, we samapam, we say it samapam, we samap the puja, we end the puja and we do worship Shankara. That is the, because we need to, because we have worshipped all the five heads of the Shiva till Ishana in the morning, okay, with each pair. And now we want that all that puja and the karma to be consolidated and given as a blessing. And that so, is the work of Shankara actually.
So this is on Wednesday evening, right, Akshat?
Tuesday evening, 9th.
Tuesday night?
Tuesday is 9th, I think, right?
No. Sorry, I'm talking of the Shivratri. We begin.
Shivratri is on 11th night, Thursday night, Indian time.
So Thursday night it begins, and then we finish all the way on Friday. So the Jagran is on Thursday night, yeah?
Right. Yes. That is the, because I usually do it with the Indian Panchang, but people can see when the Chaturdashi is falling and the local time and when the sun is setting from there. When the sun is setting, then the first pair of the Shivratri start, because there are eight pairs, four in the daytime, four in the night time. And the first pair of the night, the main Shiva Puja will start.
Correct.
Yes.
Yeah. So, in fact, when we did it in Bhimtal, we were told to do the Shiva mantra for 2 years.
Yeah.
I know.
He asked us to do 10 malas of the Shiva mantra for 2 years.
See, that is, the first is the 10 malas of Shiva Panchakshi mantra has to be done not for 2 years, it has to be done for 3 years actually. Then you have to reach a certain level of the count. Once you've done the 10 malas for the Shiva Panchakshi mantra for 3 years, then you are actually like a Shudra Brahman.
Okay.
Yeah.
You have to complete 1.5 some million repetitions of the japa, then you like the Brahman, and from there you're going to rise above.
Okay. Yeah.
Because what we
even in my Vedanta class, my teacher Swaminiji told us to do the Shiva Panchakshari for 1 month in advance. You know that the last Shivratri that happened, right? The Chaturdashi, the month. Yeah, exactly. I think it was February 11th it happened. And from there till March 11th, we are, you know, so we've been doing the Panchakshari like for like that 10.
That is a very good remedy. And there are so many different, yeah, that is a good thing actually. The best thing is to worship, do the, we have to do this. Masik Shivratri is also very good. And we can also do this on a Shivratri Puja actually. One of the best things is to do the Shiva Puja is to do during the month when in which sign your sun is.
Mm.
That is the main point, because where the sun is, there is the Shiva, that you have to do worship at that. If suppose I was born in 27th October, so my sun is in Libra. So as soon as the sun enters into Libra, that is Tula Sankranti, till Tula Sankranti, till the next Sankranti, that is Vrishik Sankranti, I have to worship Shiva so that I can get all these blessings actually.
Interesting.
Okay. There are different traditions. Guruji has taught so many things. They are different. One is the fasting when you give away the salt actually for till the Shivratri from the Sankranti. That is a very, very major, that is a very, very hard fast. And this time, because I felt sick, I used to keep it every year.
That's a very good fast.
That is how you, because Shiva Ratri is one of the very auspicious days that comes in a year that you can dissolve a lot of your bad karma, you can get a lot of your things done during the Mahashivratri. That is one of the most important festivals celebrated in India actually.
Yeah.
Anybody who cannot do so, because he is giving everything actually.
Yeah.
All the planets worship Shiva with different names actually.
Yeah.
That is the thing. Sun worships him as Shiva, Jupiter worships as Shambhu, Saturn worships him as Mahadev, Rahu worships him as Pashupati, Venus worships Mahadev, Shiva as Shulapani, Mars worships him as Pinakine. So every planet that is worshiping Shiva with a different name, when you start taking, but that's why we people say, oh, you start doing Shiva Sahasranam, all your problems are going away, because everything is getting pacified. There's so much material actually. We can start.
It'll be good to do the Shiva Sahasranam during the Shivratri time too, right?
You can do Shiva Sahasranam also, and you have to see which Shiva Sahasranam is suitable for you depending on upon your chart. Or anybody who cannot do the Shiva Sahasranam, they can simply just chant Om Namah Shivaya. That is good.
Yeah.
See, once you go into more and more elaborate puja, the results will be much better, but you need to be that much consistent in doing that.
Yeah.
So it is better that if you don't want to follow any rules, don't want to do anything fast, just do Om Namah Shivaya. That is a prasiddha mantra actually. That was the people who were talking about why you ask for a condition that you have to be vegetarian. Because the mantra that I am giving from Vedas actually. These are Vedic mantras, and there are a difference between Vedic mantras, there are difference between prasiddha mantras actually. With Vedic mantras, you have to follow certain rules and regulations. Because once you started doing this mantras, the mantra deva is going to come and sit inside your hip chakra. He does not want that body to be full of tamas. What happens if the mantra deva gets angry, the mantra's result are not going to come. It will work as a negative mantra. So we have to be careful what things we are going to do. So that's why I prescribe people to do simple pujas. It is better to do simple pujas and get results, not to do elaborate pujas. Better it is simple actually. I think we should call up today. It's been good session actually.
Okay. Yeah. Thank you. Nice. Thank you, Shyamlaji. Thank you, Akshat.
And Akshat, will we get our video recording?
Yeah. I think that because once we get done with the second session also, and I think I'll upload it, or Sonal Didi will upload it on her channel actually.
Okay.
Yeah, the divinations. I will upload it everywhere. Okay. So don't worry.
And I will send you that Shanti mantra.
I got
Shanti mantra. You can send it to the group.
Okay. Take care, Shanti.
Thank you, Shyamlaji. Uh-huh. Thank you, everyone. Om Namah Shivaya, and see you Tuesday.
Om Namah Shivaya.
Thank you, everyone.
Bye.
Grateful.